Okay, that was pretty cool. I feel like, at least at the very beginning, it felt like almost like Jimi Hendrix at the beginning, like with the wow, you know, the phaser that was going pretty fast, and like, you know, the Stratocaster with like all the overdrive sustain. Hello everyone, and welcome to the sound. My name is Matthew, and I have today special guests. With me today, I have Evelyn Holland. Evelyn is an awesome singer-songwriter. She is playing in music with Keys of Solomon. Hello and welcome to the show, Evelyn.
Hi, it's probably about my, I don't know, 50th or so panel. It's, yeah. I've been enjoying it the past couple months.
All right, and look at you, Kyle. You've got your display in the back digital, man. Cool. Yeah. A little bit more contrast maybe next time, but I can almost read it says Kyle Walz. Yeah. How you doing? Well,
all right. Yeah. Actually, I used that live. I made that. It has when it rotates colors. I don't know.
Cool.
On my screen, it just went through some contrast, but it'll be brighter. And then as it changes, it's easier to read and stuff. But yeah, live, that always gets some attention.
Yeah. Excellent, man. Excellent. And so with my brother and sister here, we're going to have some good reactions today, because The Sound Live is the show where we do music reactions and we share songs that we love. And also, you guys get a pick. That's right. Every episode of The Sound is a crowd pick that's picked by popular demand. Make sure you mash that subscribe button and that like button for Evelyn Holland and for Kyle Walz and for myself here at Matthew's Music Lesson Studio. Eve, why don't you introduce this for us?
Oh, it's so I figured I'd do Robin Trower. And I don't know if any of you are familiar with Robin Trower. No?
I'm not sure.
You probably heard this song. It's like his signature song, Bridge of Sighs. That's kind of you probably get a Jimi Hendrix vibe off of it, like that kind of cosmic blues sort of vibe. But he has a lot of stuff that's a lot more energetic and a lot funkier. I would compare him, like him and do you guys know who Frank Marino is, or Mahogany Rush?
Think so.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, I would put him in the same boat as that guitarist. He's Frank Marino's Canadian, and Robin Trower is, I believe, he's from the UK. He was in Procol Harum for a while. I'm sure you've heard A Whiter Shade of Pale.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, definitely.
And he struck out on his own after being in that group like five years or so. And yeah, he's been pretty moderately successful since the mid-70s. So yeah, I mean, he's still, with the exception of COVID, he's toured pretty consistently most years since then.
Mm-hmm. Right on. All right. Well, I'm excited to do this. I'm definitely excited to do this. And without further ado, Musicians Panel reacts to Robin Trower, Bridge of Sighs, 1974 UK TV appearance, high quality HQ. Here we go.
Thank you.
Pretty cool. I feel like, at least at the very beginning, it felt like almost like Jimi Hendrix at the beginning, like with wow, you know, the phaser that was going pretty fast, and like, you know, the Stratocaster with like all the overdrive sustain. It almost felt like a Jimmy kind of vibe at the beginning. And then, you know, I thought it was really cool how the drummer was just so subdued the whole time. And I mean, for that to really go off, the drummer and the bass player like needed to be subdued. And the bass was pretty like almost loopy, but it was still kind of like really groovy. And I've definitely heard that before. Now that I've heard it. But I was one of those songs, you know, I never would have known the lyrics or the title or whatever, or the artist, but it was cool. And I like the guitar solos. Not my taste per se, but then once it got going, I felt like there was more like of a Stevie Ray Vaughan kind of feel than Jimi Hendrix. Like it was the same tone and effects and whatever, but I felt like there was more of like, yeah, it was slower than Stevie Ray. It wasn't as much of the, I mean, but it was a slow song. You know, the song was really, really slow. And it was one of those, it was things where
he's got funk.
You get everything you can out of every single note, you know?
Yes. He's got funkier songs, like ones that are super energetic and like up tempo and everything, but he's also got stuff that's kind of down tempo and like that.
It was chill. It was real chill.
Yeah.
What do you think, Kyle?
I really like this one. I know I've heard this countless times growing up, and I heard my brother play this when I should have been in bed, but I was faking it just to hear him play guitar through the night. I wasn't sure if it was a phaser or a Leslie speaker. You know, he's using to get that kind of grindy, wah, 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 you know, that phaserish.
It might have been
sound.
A Leslie. Yeah,
it could have been. Yeah. Definitely had Hendrix vibes up front, but then to me it shifted more into Cream mode, and I was hearing a lot of Clapton.
Sure. The bass, especially the vocals. Yeah, they had sort of a Cream vibe. I can feel that.
Yeah, and thinking like 74, like after Procol Harum, a lot of Vietnam vets coming back, and some of the ways that youth culture was changing because of that. You could hear a lot of that reflected in this song. And you know, songs like this to me always kind of take me back in time, you know, like something I can't personally experience. This is kind of like a weird little partial time machine. You can go back. It's like, what did something feel like? What did a time and place feel like? And it's stuff like this that really, really communicates that for you. Talking about Clapton, it reminded me the solo part, some of Clapton's work on My Guitar Gently Weeps, which I hate. I want to love how Clapton plays in that, but I hear how he's bending notes. I'm like going, oh, please stop, stop.
Okay.
And,
yeah.
Yeah. And in this, you know, and I know it's live, and when you're live playing guitar, I would assume that the guitar was really, really loud when they were playing this. And that has a big factor in how you determine pitches, you know, with the rest of the band or your own playing. I wish some of the bends in this, unless he's doing that on purpose, you know, and I could see, and that's what I started to get me thinking, was he purposely making, kind of hearkening to some of the old blues where you have that in between a minor and major third. Mm-hmm. You know, it's almost like an extra note.
Yeah, I totally.
Yeah.
Very so blues note, right?
Yeah. Bending notes, not only to a selected pitch, but also bending notes to an in-between pitch intentionally to create that grinding.
Yeah.
Like on saxophone, you know, I'll combine playing intentionally a little bit out of tune with growling, maybe on tune or maybe out of tune in a different way, just to really, and then resolve it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And so, you know, not knowing the words or some of this, but just thinking back to, you know, 1974 and what a time of change that was, you know, here in the States and in the UK and many, many other places on this planet. You know, and just thinking, you know, is he trying to communicate something like that? Or was he just, you know, not hearing what he was playing? And sometimes as a guitar player, it's like you go to make a bend and it hits your finger weird. And you're like, oh, it's not really on my callus. And you got all these other things that you're combating as you're playing. Or maybe your hand's sweaty too, you know. What Eve said.
So on the final version, it'll be Eve will go, and then Kyle says, what Eve said.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, what did Eve say? What did Eve say?
Okay. As a guitar player, I mean, unless you don't like that guitar tone, hearing a Strat sound like that is one of the, like, holy grail guitar sounds. You know, that's just one of those things.
Yeah.
You hear it and it just does something, you know, there's just a whole lot of nostalgia, a whole lot of power in that tone. So,
well, don't hate, but you know, I always preferred Les Pauls. I'm not a Strat
searing.
Guy. I never was a Strat guy.
Yeah.
I like what Strat guys do with Strats, Okay, don't get me wrong. I like what strat guys do with strats, but I'm not a strat guy. I was always more of the humbucker type guy myself. And that's just my personal tonal preference. We got new ways to support the channel. Exclusive weekly bonus content on Patreon, patreon.com/Matthew's Music Lesson Studio. We've got liberapay.com/Matthew's Music, where you can donate weekly, and it's a nonprofit, so I get the most money there as far as them taking no fees. Definitely, you can buy me a coffee right now, buymeacoffee.com/Matthew's Music. And also Venmo, send me a tip on Venmo at Matthew's Music. I really appreciate you guys. And go ahead and please
right now,
subscribe to all these guys' channels. Subscribe to Eve's channel. Subscribe to Kyle's channel. Make sure you mash that like button. Okay.
Hey, here's an idea too, thinking about what you said earlier. People use Spotify. Look us all up on Spotify, make a playlist.
Yeah.
You talked about Kilo Metro One. Mm-hmm. You know, help musicians out, because you know, you get, you know, a couple handfuls of people that do that, you know, a few times a week. That does start to help after a while.